Simmental was our grand champion of its breed show for the Dolivers, JT Greater Consensus 113E. Is it even worth what I'm fighting for anymore? Feeling torn. Our always popular Speckle Park show featured this two-year-old as its grand champion on Wednesday, DAM Dots 94A Electric 31E for Dustin McAleer of Unity Saskatchewan and McAleer Ranching. This was our grand champion Speckle Park Bull, the two-year-old DAM Dots 94A Electric 31E. Speckle Park Farm Fair Grand Champion Bull. We move now to Olds Fall Classic, where DMM Glock 94E was the grand champion Black Angus Bull. This two-year-old, owned by Miller Wilson Angus of Basha, Alberta, Freeway Angus and Arta Farms of Acme, Alberta, was the grand champion Black Angus Bull at the first of the shows to kick off the Alberta Supreme Run, the Olds Fall Classic, and DMM Glock 94E, the two-year-old grand champion Black Angus Bull. And the grand champion Red Angus Bull from Olds Fall Classic, who also won the Lloydminster Stockade Roundup for the Shiloh Boys of Craigmile, Alberta, Shiloh Cattle Company with Red DKF Racer 8E. This is the two-year-old bull that is a two-time Alberta Supreme qualifier, winning both Lloyd and Olds. Red DKF Racer 8E, the grand champion Red Angus for Shiloh Cattle Company. And our three Lloydminster grand champions not already in the ring include the grand champion Black Angus Bull, the two-year-old DMM Crank 13E from the Wilson family of Miller Wilson Angus at Bashaw and Nelsie Hershey Purebreds. Our grand champion Black Angus Bull from Lloydminster is DMM Crank 13E. The Sherem Shinsky family of NCX Pulled Herefords had our grand champion Hereford Bull at Lloydminster Stockade Roundup. It was the bull calf, NCX Giorgio 2G. Congratulations to NCX Pulled Herefords, the Lloydminster Stockade Roundup grand champion Hereford Bull, the bull calf, NCX Giorgio 2G. And our final challenger in our Supreme Championship is the Grand Champion Simmental from Lloydminster Stockade Roundup from Willerton Simmental, Trevor Willerton and crew of Streamstown, Alberta. This is RWS Ferdinand 551F, the yearling Simmental Bull that was our Grand Champion Simmental at Lloydminster Stockade Roundup for Team Willerton Simmental. RWS Ferdinand 551F. This is the grand champion Simmental Bull from Lloyd and the final contender of our 15 outstanding bulls. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together if you want to know where's the beef. It's right here in Hall D.
So, Rob, would it be okay if I go back to that DLMS statistics again, if you don't mind? I'm just going to talk a little bit about DLMS, and Mark and Joanne Shulligan and the crew attend all three of our partnership events, and they live stream to the globe. And we are so grateful for the work that they do, but I do have some analytics I wanted to share with you that over the course of Farm Fair International, over 2,700 people watched our shows live over the course of the 4 days. In the post-show production, there was over 5,000 views, which is absolutely incredible. And we also were excited that of those folks that tuned in, they represent over 2,200 countries around the world that were interested to tune in to Farm Fair International. One statistic in particular is last year during the Alberta Supreme, there was over 1,000 people tuned in online. So that is super cool. When we talk about bringing Farm Fair International to the world, we have amazing guests that invest in coming here personally to visit with our exhibitors and partners and industry leaders. But thank you to DLMS for bringing the show to everyone else in the globe. I'm just looking up to the stand. Would it be okay if we do another exhibitor draw?
Of course.
Okay, Lindsay, let's do it. We're gonna do another $500 exhibitor draw. So we'll ask our technical crew to get your 90-second clock teed up and ready to go. Again, this is compliments of Farm Fair investing in their exhibitors and thanking them for coming. Lindsay Crow, our manager here, is pulling out another name. And this is for $500 cash. You have 90 seconds on the clock. Avalon Angus, the Hofstra crew. So any member of the Hofstra family, please safely come to the dirt and we'll have some cash for you. Oh, it's going. So congratulations to Avalon Angus. They are the lucky recipients of another $500 cash. Don't spend it all at once, sir. Congratulations. I can feel them flying like a hand out the window as the cars go
by. It's all we've been given. So, Trace, last night your mother made the comment that if she was a person sitting in the stands watching all of the shows this week, that was paying attention to the comments that were made, one of the absolute highlights and one of the focuses of Farm Fair International 2019 would be the Champion of the World initiative. I think now would be a good time for us to have PJ Butler and his crew come down and perhaps say a few words about the Champion of the World initiative. PJ has a little bit of the history of the program and how that started in some ways really very modestly, and that he himself is really quite blown away at how extraordinary the uptake has been and how popular it's become as it's been announced, but also for the people that are the recipients that come from around the world here to Farm Fair International to actually accept their awards. The 2018 Champion of the World competition took place last year, December 1st to 14th. And those are the ones that we have spotlighted. The seventh edition of the competition featured 1,000 champion bulls and females from 77 countries around the world, representing 16 breeds of cattle. There is an esteemed panel of four that judges each breed, and they differ from breed to breed. But there is never two people from the same country that judge the same breed. They are divided into regions, and the females actually have the opportunity to vie for Miss, their region, and ultimately becoming Miss World. And in the case of the bulls, then they become the champion of whatever the region is. And once those champions are declared, they become the champion of the world. And we are so excited that we have had the champion of the world group here over the course of the last few days. I know that PJ's now on a plane on his way down to Florida, but we still have Emily Lochner with us. And is Lee still with us? Yeah, Lee is with us as well. From Champion of the World Genetics and Marketing to hand out the awards. Tracy, do you want to have a little chat with our folks down there and talk about their experiences at Farm Fair? Because I think for both of them, it's maybe their first trip to Farm Fair.
Is that true, guys? This is your Farm Fair newbies. So tell us, Lee, what has been your favorite memory of Farm Fair International 2019 thus far?
And it's all been fantastic. I've been really grateful for the effort that Charlotte Wasilik has put into just making sure that we've been very welcomed here. I come here from the Dallas-Fort Worth area down in Texas, and so it's just been seamless, and y'all have done a great job. I've been super excited just walking around the pens, seeing everybody and seeing all the animals. We've got some gorgeous beasts up here, and so it's been a lot of fun.
Awesome. And Emily, as someone who has shown cattle my entire life, I've always had a bucket list of shows. And the majors are always fun to attend and get to meet new people and see how they do it in different areas. Tell me a little bit about your bucket list and what Farm Fair has done to achieve on that bucket list.
Well, you know, I've seen this before. You think about all the shows in the world that you want to go to, and how can you not put some of the great Canadian shows up at the top? And Farm Fair's got to be in it. I think the international component here is unmatched, and you guys do such an unrivaled quality job of bringing people together. I think people often lose the facts of gathering with your contemporaries and sharing ideas and sharing semen and embryos, and what a great platform to do it in Edmonton with so many great cattle and now the all-breed supreme of the world. You guys do a stand-up job, and we're just so grateful to be here.
Well, thank you guys so much. I know Sheremy Viator said when she was up for our Fall Classic show that we're as tough a competition as you'll find anywhere, but we're really friendly people. So we always welcome our international folks to come and enjoy the camaraderie that also comes with showing cattle. And so we really appreciate the commitment that you guys have in terms of the champions of the world. And so we're delighted to have you. Thank you so much for coming. Yeah, let's put our hands together for the champions of the world, guys. This is awesome. And of course, Emily and Lee and PJ and a number of their contemporary groups have done a number of presentations over the course of the last 4 days. And it has just been an incredible experience. So do we have another award to give? We do. And does Rob know the winner of that, or do you know the winner of that?
We certainly do, and we're going to announce it right now. The Angus Champion of the World title was won by a bull from Argentina.
Rob absolutely never stops talking, and I can't see him. So is everything okay up there? All right, Emily, would you like to...
Sure. You know, so as Rob had previously mentioned, the Champion of the World competition is such a tough thing to win because we have judges represented from four different areas of the world, North America, South America, Europe, and Asia, Africa. And so to vie against not only your country and your shows here to win Agribition or Farm Fair and to be qualified in that, you have to compete against your continent and then the world, and then you compete against all the interbreeds. So as Rob mentioned, we have 16 breeds that vie against each other, and bull and female, there's 32 champions. So in early February, the 32 will be pitted against each other randomly, and one will come out what we call supreme all breeds champion of the world. And for the second year in a row, Canada has won the title, supreme all breeds champion of the world. And this year, That title went to Miller Wilson Angus with their Angus sire, D.